video, we shall understand how to find the number of imperfect squares lying between two consecutive perfect square numbers. So before that, let's recall what we mean by perfect squares and imperfect squares. What is a perfect square or a square number? If a number can be expressed as a square of some other natural number, then that number is said to be a perfect square. For example, 121, the number 121 can be written as 11 square, because you know that 11 into 11 is 121. Another example, 225. 225 is a perfect square because it can be expressed as 15 square. 15 into 15 is 225. So 225 is a perfect square or a square number. So like this you can give infinite examples. Then what is an imperfect square? If a number cannot be expressed as a square of some other natural number, then that number is an imperfect square. For example, 90 cannot be expressed as a square of some other natural number. Hence, 90 is not a perfect square, it is an imperfect square. Now here, I have listed all the natural numbers from 1 to 25. Now we know that 1 is a perfect square. 4 is also a perfect square. 1 and 4 are two consecutive perfect square numbers. Now, between these two consecutive perfect square numbers, we have two imperfect squares. 2 is an imperfect square. 3 is an imperfect square. So, between 1 and 4, 1 and 4 are two consecutive perfect square numbers. Between these two, we have two imperfect squares. Now check the number of imperfect squares between 4 and 9. 4 is a perfect square. 9 is also a perfect square. Between the two consecutive perfect squares 4 and 9, we have 4 imperfect squares. 1, 2, 3, 4 imperfect squares. Again, between 9 and 16. Between 9 and 16. 9 is a perfect square. 16 is a perfect square. After 9, 16 is the next perfect square. 9 and 16 are two consecutive perfect square numbers. And between them we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 imperfect squares lying between 9 and 16. Going on like this, 16 and 25 are perfect squares. In fact, 16 and 25 are consecutive perfect square numbers that come one after the other. So now between 16 and 25, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 imperfect squares. Between 16 and 25, we have 8 imperfect squares or 8 natural numbers lying between 16 and 25. So what we've been seeing is the number of imperfect squares or the number of natural numbers lying between two consecutive perfect squares. So see the rhythm. First we have 2, then we have 4, 6, 8. So this should continue with 10, 12, 14. So what are these numbers? These are multiples of 2. See here, 2, 4, 6, 8. So the next one should be 10, then 12, 14. To go on like that. So you see that these numbers are multiples of 2. And hence, the expression to find the number of natural numbers or imperfect squares between two consecutive perfect squares is 2n. Why 2n? Because it's a multiple of 2. So see here, 2 into 1 or it should be 2 into 2. See here, 2 in, what is 2? 2 into 1. Here 2 into 2, 2 into 3. So see here, 2 into n, 2 into n. Here 2 into n where n is 1. 2 into n where n is 2. 2 into n where n is 3. 2 into n where n is 4. So it goes on like that. So 2n is the expression which is used to find the number of imperfect squares lying between two consecutive perfect square numbers.